everybody, I'm Adam.
And I'm Jay.
Welcome to the Movie Preview Review, where we review movies based on only watching their previews.
And today, we're not going to do a trailer reaction.
Nope.
It's what we normally do.
What? We're breaking the mold.
What's happening? Today, we're actually going to do an actual review. Something you guys have been asking for us. Something for... I'm just too excited. You guys have been asking for us to do... quite some time.
Yeah.
So now we're doing it.
We're doing it. We're extending doing the brand it. A little bit.
Oh, can you what? Feel the brand extending? Oh, we're just stretching the walls out. Woo!
Boy, We went to go see a movie, and now we're going to talk about it.
Yeah.
Same way we usually do with movie trailers, but this time with an actual movie.
Mm-hmm.
A full-length two-hour movie
that
we saw, and now we're going to talk about it.
I think they get it.
You know how these things work.
I think they understand. They probably read the thumbnail and they're like, why are you still telling us what you're doing? So we saw Ant-Man.
And the Wasp.
Yeah.
Actually, it's more like The Wasp featuring Ant-Man. So Jay, what did you think of the movie?
I really liked it. I had a great time. It was really fun. Had enough goofs. Had enough ants. You know?
Yes, there were a lot of ants.
But I walked out of the theater and I was thinking to myself, I was like, that is, and I mean this in a good way, that is the most aggressively fine Marvel movie. Like, it was good.
Yes.
It was great. It was a great time. Yep. Had all the pieces I wanted. Mm-hmm. It had, like, the story was, like, pretty straightforward, but it had some twists and turns to it.
Mm-hmm.
But it was, like, it was a nice return to the Marvel formula.
Yes.
Since... the most recent Avengers.
Yes.
You know what I mean? I was not blown away by this movie, but I didn't need to be.
Nope.
It was kind of like, it was a delicious champagne sorbet to cleanse my palate from what just happened. You know what I mean?
Yeah. This movie was the most, like, Marvel movie because, like, you really needed to know what happened in the original Ant-Man and the first Ant-Man. Captain America.
Kimberly did not.
And there were many story points.
Ant-Man, and she kept asking questions.
Oh, see, because that's what I was thinking. If you're not a Marvel fan, you may not. Even though they had agent exposition at the beginning, like here's some things that are going on.
They did a pretty good job.
They did a pretty good job, but like to really appreciate the movie, you really needed to see most of Phase 3.
Yeah, she asked what was asking all the questions. But I didn't. It was like one of those things where it was kind of like, I was like, oh, we'll talk about it later. And I was kind of upset, but I didn't blame her because I was like, no, this is kind of confusing. I was like, if you don't really know, if you didn't see, like, Civil War, like, even though she saw Civil War. So
she didn't remember it.
It's fine.
You married her, it's fine. You're stuck with her.
Yep.
That's my wife! But no, this movie was really good. It was funny. Like, it's exactly what we all needed. Especially what I needed. Like, my theater was rolling with laughter.
Yeah, like, really I don't know it. If it was as funny as, like, Thor Ragnarok, though. I was actually surprised at how... Okay. It may have been the theater I was in. I also saw it really early in the morning, because that's when I had time to see it. and so the theater... It was a Saturday. I mean, you know. So the theater maybe have been a little dead. But some of the jokes, like, didn't totally land all the time. And I was like, I wish her, like, this was as funny as Thor. It still had some good goofs. Don't get me wrong.
I thought
Paul Rudd's just great.
Well, I think that what they did, they extended the size changing abilities and stuff for the humor even more so than the first one.
Oh yeah.
And I thought that was a great source of humor. I mean, all of the physical stuff that they did with size changings and stuff, I thought was hilarious.
Well, yeah. I mean, you gotta explore that more.
But also, I think, as much as this movie is. You know, straight down the middle, easy, very easily digestible, nothing super crazy. You know, it feels good. I think this movie has probably the best choreographed fight scenes in all of Marvel's 10-year history.
That is a bold statement.
It is a bold statement.
Better than even the Captain America fights?
Yeah.
Really?
Here's why.
Because all the shrinking?
Because of the powers in play of the changing of the sizes and stuff and the abilities. That adds another two layers to the action. Because Cap's fights are great, because there's always the punching and the thinking, because Cap, you know, he's got the shield.
That's all they got, though.
That's all they got.
The fighting's got to be crazy, because that's what they're working with.
But with this, even though there's a ton of CG involved...
I'll take that. I'll agree with that.
Especially with Evangeline Lilly's character, like, yeah, the Wasp, like, this is...
She wears some bad wigs, dude. Woof. She wears some bad wigs. I know I bring this up all the time, but there's some... The... Man. I
don't know. Was her main...
And there's all the flashback stuff. All the flashback stuff. It's mainly from the first movie. It's still... But it carried over, and I was like, are we really going back to this wig? Oh, wow. Wow. Well, I mean, the best moment in the movie for me, personally, was the... and this is in the trailer, so there's no spoilers. We'll get to spoilers later.
Yeah.
When she throws the salt shaker and then hits it with the growth thing, mm-hmm. I was like, yes. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Uh-huh.
It's whoever wrote this, or whoever, and especially whoever, like, took those sentences from the page and, like, made them onto screen. I was like, this is what's going to actually happen. Like, they deserve all of the credit and all of the money, because they did a fantastic job of really making these action scenes clever, funny, and exciting.
Yeah.
And that's hard to do. But, like, with the powers they had available, they really thought outside the box and, like, really pushed them to the limits. Especially with... I mean, because Evangeline Lilly was, like, trained. Like, she was the one... In the first one, she wanted to be Ant-Man.
Yeah.
And they're like, no, Scott. But, like, so this time it's like, I've been training. I know actually how to kick everyone's ass. I could do it without the suit. And then, but with the suit, it's not even fair. It's so good. Oh, she kicks everyone's ass. Man.
God. Should we get into, should we go past the spoiler wall?
I think let's go past the spoiler wall.
Spoilers!
We're going into the spoiler realm.
The spoiler realm. Which is, they built a tunnel to go to the spoiler room.
A big tunnel. Okay, here's the thing. Nothing happens in this movie. Have you noticed that? Like, nothing actually happened in this movie. Which is good.
What do you mean?
What do you mean? They get Janet back from... Sure, they got Janet back. But, like, this movie was very small and very self-contained.
Sure.
And very, like, in San Francisco.
It's kind of what we needed it to be Avengers, though.
We absolutely needed it to be. We needed it to be it.
Okay.
But it was very much like, I left the theater, I'm like, I'm really happy I saw that.
It's fine.
Fine. Good. But, like, yeah, it didn't, well, I couldn't really push the story forward a little at all, because, you know, it takes place right before Avengers 4 and everything happens in that movie. But this movie also doesn't have a villain. I honestly thought,
oh, the arms dealer guy could be classified as an actual villain.
Technically, sure. But I thought that...
And Ghost was technically a villain.
Using the Marvel formula, as you said earlier...
Okay.
Marvel has been known for weak villains. And because their heroes are so compelling and good and written well.
Yeah.
But I felt like this time, it was like, you know what? Like, technically, yes, Ghost was the villain. But, like, ultimately, like, no one died in this movie. I don't think a single person died.
That FBI dude gets straight up.
I think her hand is just on the outside of his chest.
I'm pretty sure that guy got his heart ripped out.
Maybe that guy. Maybe. But we saw that Hank survived this whole little thing, this jobber.
Yeah.
So maybe we just get, you know, ow, it really hurts for a second. I'm down. Buddy, I'm okay. We never saw a body. We never saw an on-screen body.
She's not... If she has her hand through his neck, she's not going to make herself physical, because that's just weird. Like, oh, now I got a corpse on my house. Yuck. Also, there's, like, bones in there. Like, you're going to... You're not... Your arm's not going to be okay after doing that.
Probably not.
That's not going to go
probably
good
not.
For you. Probably
not. No.
Although, you've been trained by the government, so who knows? Maybe
who knows?
You can. I don't know
maybe
what
she's
you're
really good
capable
at that.
Of. I have no clue. They didn't really explain her totally, and that's fine.
And that's fine, because honestly, I felt like this movie was like, you know what? We know what this movie has to be. It's coming after Avengers 4. The world doesn't know what we're about to do to them.
Yeah.
This one needs to be kind of light and fluffy and
yeah.
fun, and you know, so you know what? We really don't need a villain.
Yeah.
And because she really was kind of just like an antagonist of like, she just had a goal,
uh-huh.
who like, I really need to not die. And she did, yes, she crossed the line, like, with a couple of toes, but, like, not really. She didn't really do anything super bad at all the whole time.
She killed that FBI.
I don't know if she killed that guy.
Dude, that guy's dead.
I don't know.
That guy is dead.
Let us know if you think that guy's dead.
Let us know if you think that guy's dead.
What was Agent Random Douchey White Agent?
I will say, I could have watched, is it Michael Pena?
Yeah.
I could have watched him on Truth Serum for another 15 minutes. That was, as soon as, like, the Truth Serum came out and the whole conversation, like, it's not Truth Serum. There's no such thing as Truth Serum. Like, the whole thing, I was like, man, they're going to inject him and they're not even know what they're going to deal with. And this is, and it lived up to the hype and it was spectacular. But I wanted more.
Yeah. Well, that was one of the cool things about the movie is that they were able to pretty much bring back every joke from the first one.
Yeah.
And twist it a little bit and represent it.
And they also brought back all the people that we liked in a way that made sense to me.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Like, it didn't feel like they were just like, oh, we gotta have Pena and the boys. We gotta have, T.I.'s gotta be there somewhere. Mm-hmm. I was like, no. I was like, him starting a security agency, actually, that makes sense.
Makes actual sense.
That actually tracks.
Yeah.
My only issue with this movie.
Okay.
My only issue. And it would have been so easy to explain. They could have had one line. If your building is tiny and small, and it's being passed around from cars to cars, and you're powering a huge tunnel to the quantum realm,
mm-hmm.
where is all of that electricity coming from? Moreover, if you just, like, make the building big in the middle of the forest, how are you connecting to the power grid? What are they... All they would have had to have done would have been like, oh, yeah, like, we made this big lithium battery, you know?
Yeah.
That, like, you know, like, those little batteries
it's like
that,
a
like,
quantum battery, let's say.
Like, yeah, it's like just a little lithium battery that you use to, like, power your phones, but it's like, oh, it just made it huge. And then we put it on the side of the building.
Oh,
and we're powering everything that way.
Yes.
Could have taken 2 seconds to explain it, because I was like, they're going to die in there, because that building's just getting tossed around, and there's no power!
That's, you know what, that's a very good, yes, I didn't think
of
that.
Thank God they didn't show anyone using the bathroom, because I'm like, where's the plumbing? It's not hooked up to the water supply at all!
Yeah, that's what I was wondering, too. But my actual question when I was left the theater was, where did Janet get that robe? That.
Dude, she's straight up murked a tardigrade.
Which also.
On the way down and made it into a coat.
Which was the
a
only.
Sweet, sweet tardigrade coat.
Which was the only. When he's going through the quantum realm, he's like, trigger, trigger, trigger. Like, oh, there's tardigrades. I said it out loud. And I think, like, to myself. But this, I think, was the only. It's like, oh, I'm glad I watched Star Trek Discovery because I know that's a tardigrade. And it's the only time I've ever said that sentence.
See, yeah, I said it out loud as well, and I said, oh, I thank God I listened to The Adventure Zone. I know what a tardigrade is.
Oh!
Yeah, but I said, oh, those are tardigrades. And Kimberly just goes, she kind of looked at me like, okay. And then finally she's like, oh, watch out for those tardigrades. And Kimberly was like, how do you know what those are? like, not in like a, oh, how do you, you're so smart. She was just like, why do you know
that?
You
are a giant nerd.
Like, not even a nerd, just like, some, you know, sometimes like you have knowledge about things and it's just like, when it comes out, it's like, you should be using your time better.
Yeah.
Like, we only get so much time on this earth. Like, figure it out, man.
But that was like, everything was very heartfelt and the reunion was so nice, but like when Janet shows up, it's because you know she was going to get saved. I was like, where did you get that sweet Jedi robe? Why are you taking it? You can breathe in the quantum zone? That's pretty cool. Like, it was just those, like,
why,
again.
Why wouldn't you be able to breathe?
Because, I don't know, does air molecules shrink down to the quantum zone?
Oh, that's a good question.
Because that's why Scott
that.
Needed to have the suit on.
Because you're smaller than oxygen.
Exactly. So you needed to bring your own oxygen supply.
I never even thought about it. Like
that's
that.
Why the thing. So it was just like, yes, she's got powers now, which is cool. But again, like maybe a sentence of just, maybe that she evolved and didn't need to eat.
I don't know, man. I'm curious to see, like, what her situation is going to be.
She's going
to
be...
Because she's got all that quantum energy.
Yeah, she's
going to
be quantum wasp. Because, you know, we're just throwing quantum in the front of words now.
Yeah,
so
man.
It's fine.
Quantum cola. Yum. I drink that. I drink the shit out of that.
So, yeah, no, I thought, you know, the plot was good. It was straightforward. There were a couple of twists and turns. Nothing super crazy.
Uh-huh.
But just, you know, it was fun. Like, the last whole chase scene... was last, what, 15 minutes or so?
Yeah.
It was just, like, fun. It was really just a fun, good, just
yeah,
easy
I had a great
movie.
Time. Easy movie. Easy peasy. Lemon squeezy.
But here's the round,
now, I think we're in double spoilers.
Double spoilers.
I think we're in the spoiler quantum zone.
Yeah.
Spoiler quantum zone! Yo, Ant-Man's gonna get Gamora out of the Spirit Gem, huh?
Okay. So let me, before we, yes. So, back when we did the review or the reaction to the trailer for this thing.
Yeah, it's kind of funny, actually. We did, basically did an Avengers, review in the Ant-Man trailer.
Yeah.
So this is a weird flip-flop.
A little bit. We totally guessed correctly that one of the post-credit scenes was going to be people falling to the to snap. Now, I was shocked that it was three of them. I honestly thought it was just going to be like Hank and Janet.
Uh-huh.
But I'm surprised it took Hope too. But also the fact, like, Janet, welcome back! Inside of a week, you made a smaller quantum tunnel and you're dead! Like, damn it! And I'm glad they didn't show it. I'm so... Because here's the thing. We are... Avengers came out the end of April. We are now at the beginning of July. So it's really only... Like 2 months? We're 2 months removed from the events of the snap. And I'm thinking, you know what? I'm okay. You know, I'm emotionally, I'm okay. Like, it was really sad.
I think that hit you harder than it hit me.
It was really sad, and, you know, all these things happened, and you know what? But logically, I know everything's probably going to be mostly fine.
I think everyone's
going to be back. We know the slate of movies coming in face. We know everything's fine.
Yeah. That's how comic books work.
That's how comic books work. Totally aware. It's got to get sucked in. It's like, all right, everybody, like, you got the thing. Time to go. Guys? Guys? Cut to, and there's just dust, and it hit me all over again. I am actively upset. Like, I am aware that I'm taking this way too personally.
Is it weird that, like, that post-credit sequence actually kind of, like, solidified the movie for me as a whole? Like, that was, like, the final, like, cherry on the sundae where I was like, yes, okay. I was like, I understand. Like, this movie was setting up what's going to happen next. And it's like, yeah, it's good to know where Scott is, and then we get another Marvel movie, and that's wonderful. But it's like, oh, it was more, I got excited because I was like, everything leading up to, like, from Marvel is leading up to the next Avengers. And I'm here for it. I'm just here for it. Dude, he ain't going to be in that quantum realm for very long.
No.
I really thought we were going to see, like, Gamora somewhere.
Oh, really?
Oh, yeah.
Oh.
I really thought he was going to, like, hear a voice or something. Like, what's that? That's the only thing that makes any sense, right?
Well, that they can get down to the quantum level, that maybe when Doctor Strange comes back, because they were talking about quantum level looks a lot like when he was traversing space-time or whatever he was doing.
Oh, sure.
So, everything before the credits. Happy, fun, good, like, I'm enjoying this. It's so cathartic, and yay, Marvel's fun. And then credits start rolling. Here are all these people. I love these people. Thanks for making this movie. Guys, where are you? Guys? Heart hurts. Rest of the credits. Like, my theater audibly went, ah! They groaned.
But,
yes.
It's like when you get punched. It's like when you get punched where you're already bruised. Where you're, like, kind of okay. And then you're like, like, or, like, someone, like, bumps into you and you're just like, my arm.
And I knew it was coming. I knew it was coming. But I was surprised it was all three of them. And then we get to the end of the credits. And I'm like, okay, so there's probably going to be one little scene. What could this possibly be? There's no way they're going to stick us again in the same bruise. Oh, they totally did. Because decimated. Yeah. No one's there. It's just quiet. And then Anthony's playing the thing. Hilarious, but I didn't laugh at all.
It's so
because it really solidified. Oh God, the world is effed. Half the population's gone. People's lives are destroyed. Yeah. Like I left the theater like just almost as destroyed as I did when I watched Avengers.
Yeah, man.
Because it really,
The only thing I would have changed about the movie,
sure,
if I had to.
Okay.
at the second credit sequence. Mm-hmm. The Ant thing was fine. I appreciated that they set it up. It was like, oh, everyone's gone. And like the TV's all, that's great. If it were me and I were writing that, it would have been like similar thing. But it'd be like someone at a restaurant, and, like everyone's like gone, and they're just like, they have like a big drink full of trays, and then they just like walk through the sliding door and then walk right into that salt pepper salt shaker and then just drop all the glasses everywhere and be like, damn it, this is not my day. Like, I forgot about the salt shaker. How are we supposed to get it out of here? It weighs 3 tons.
Side note, as we're wrapping this movie up, I went to that website, Did You Survive the Snap? I don't know the name of it, but there's a website
out there. Where did that, I don't know what you're talking
about.
There's
a website out there that lets you know if you survived Thanos' snap.
Oh, well, that's just like an easy, just like a coin flip.
Yeah. I did.
You did?
Yep. I'm in Marvel's Left Behind. I'm still here. So.
Do you want, is there a quiz?
Nope, it's just you just log on and just you hit the enter button. And
can I do it on your phone really quick? Or can I do it on your computer?
Yeah, do it on the computer real quick.
We'll see if I survive.
Oh, yeah.
Do you want to bring it up?
Bring it up real quick for you. Here we go. Okay, did Thanos kill me? This is for Jay.
No, Jay! Man! No!
Oh, no! Don't do it.
Can you actually edit this?
I don't know, we'll see.
I don't want to go, Mr. Lash. I don't want to go.
I'm so sad I'm taking this too personally.
Oh man, of course I got. Damn it.
Sorry, Juddy. Juddy?
Did you just call me Juddy?
Yeah, I did. I wouldn't try to say J.
J buddy?
Yeah, J buddy.
Good old Juddy.
So, I would say, see this movie. If you haven't seen it, I assume most people have seen it.
It's great.
You should see it.
We had a great time.
It's great.
It's not the best Marvel movie, but we didn't need it to be.
Nope, it's exactly... I mean, they knew what they needed to make.
Yeah.
And I think they really leaned into it.
I would have liked it to be a little bit more of a heist, but it fit the universe well, and it served the story well, so...
Yeah, it's fine. So it was really... Yeah, really good movie.
Yeah.
But, I mean, I'm more looking forward towards Captain Marvel. Like, this was this is what we needed. It's funny, like, this is what we needed to get over or help kind of band-aid... for the next, 8 months before Captain Marvel comes out. But hopefully Captain Marvel, like, she kicks a lot of ass. In that post-credits scene, they start getting the beeper page. Because she's either in, like, outer space or, like, waking up from cryo sleep or something. The only way I can think of, she's not involved in stuff.
She's fighting Adam Warlock.
And she's like, oh, I gotta go. And then, and that's how we end it before Avengers 4. But,
the after credit sequence of, mm-hmm. and I'm calling it now, is that she's going to be fighting people, and then they're all, half of them are going to turn to dust, and then her pager's going to go off. And then,
And then she's like, time to get to work. She's got to have some cool type of, like, hero line. I hope
she puts her goggles on and hits space!
Helmet collar.
To space! Captain Marvel's go-to catchphrase. To space!
That's what she says.
Uh-huh.
Uh-huh.
Goggle time! I don't know if she doesn't have goggles, but you know what I mean. It'd be cool.
It'd be very cool.
How do you fly through the vacuum of space?
Well, sometimes she's got a little half mask.
Without your eyes getting sucked out of your head. I don't care if you have superpowers.
Who knows? Well, guys, what did you think of Ant-Man and the Wasp?
What'd you think? Let us know.
Let us know in the comments below.
Are you like that we're doing reviews now?
Yes!
Is that good? Is this good?
We're gonna try to do our best to, in a timely fashion, get to some of the bigger movies.
Yeah.
And as we get a routine going, we'll probably do some more. So, it should be good. So like, subscribe, hit the bell!
Do that YouTube that you do so well!
Yeah. Guacamole is extra.
Guacamole is extra.
But honestly, since there's only half of us left, we have a surplus of guac, because there's not a whole lot of people left to eat it.
And that's why Thanos is our loving protector. Thank you, Thanos, for all of our guacamole. Praise to Thanos. Praise to Thanos.
We appreciate you guys hanging in there for so long. Wow. Good job, Adam.
And we'll talk to you later.
Thanks, Bob.
Bye. Bye. The Earth is better off with half of us. Prove me wrong.